our work is based on the familiar, potentially pedagogical activities, the PIPAs, as we call, in schools and language institutes, language classes, groups. And because we all work in this environment, so this is where we've been working and developing this. Of course, for us, PIPAs, we're going to call PIPAs, PIPAs are familiar classroom activities, as you have already said, with slight adaptations that can be used to generate useful data or can be used with the pedagogic orientation, which is to understand the activity. So if you're going to adapt, you need to understand what you're using. So with this, you criticize, you have a critical look to the activities that you have at hand or in course books or in syllabus, wherever. So there's this two ways of looking at PIPAs, and especially in classrooms. The activities are many. Right? All tests can be an activity, interviews, diaries. So if you break with the notion, traditional notion that the activities are what you have, what you've got, in this case, you can play around and create whatever you want. In this situation, we mean, they can be connected to many different situations. So they can be connected to emerging puzzles in the classroom. For example, why do we speak English? Why do Brazilians like to speak English? Why do Brazilians, these are the puzzles that came out and connected to these PIPAs. Why all the names in Portuguese are of strange, foreign origin? And why do we have foreign names and all this? So these are puzzles connected to something that happened in the classroom. Can be also linked to learners' own puzzles, like why do we have to use the apostrophe S, for instance, if it's a grammar puzzle or something like this. So adapting activities, the students will do this, or the teacher, or the group, depending on the organization of the structure of the class. And also could also be suggested by the learners, by the learners themselves, by their own puzzles, like why do I have to or the teachers, right? The learners here being teachers, the learners, why do I have to teach the present perfect now, right? So this is, and also the students, why do we have to solve? You can have many different suggestions. And also by, according to a reflexive theme that came, for example, why are my students so hostile to each other? What's this hostility in the classroom? So this is also possible. So you can see that the agentivity of teachers and learners as teachers and students as learners as well, is very much focused here when you work with PIPAs.
Thank you, Mabel.